Welcome to this special session on standing on the head and the hands. Not exactly the hands, actually, the elbows rather, and the forearms. It's called the headstand, the famous headstand. This is an advanced yoga practice that needs to be learned step by step and safely, especially as you come down from the pose. You need to stay at the bottom of the pose for quite a while before bringing your head up. That's the first warning, the one not to forget. This is an advanced yoga posture, and it's also considered as the best one, or one of the very best ones. And it's sometimes said that if you practice this 3 hours a day, every day, you become immortal. It's good because it's an inverted posture, so it brings the digestive system to a rest. It brings the heart to a rest because the heart doesn't need to pump anything anymore back into it. And it is especially good for the pineal gland and the brain, the head. And therefore, it's very good for the entire glandular system, for the hormonal system, among other things. It's also very good for the entire body tone, as you need a lot of muscles to get into this one. So, I'm going to teach you how to get there step by step, and these steps may well take you months, even years. The one other thing to be careful of is to be aware that there is quite a bit of strain on the neck, even though we try and put as much weight as possible on the arms. Still, the neck is compressed with this one. So check with your doctor that it is okay for your neck. And also, always remember to end a headstand session with a counter pose that will stretch the neck back. Good, let's get into it. First, I will show you what it is, and then we will take it bit by bit. So basically, it's about standing on the head with the help of the arms. It goes like this. Coming down is staying down. Now let's take it step by step. First of all, before you go into this one, do a few neck stretches and neck rolls. Don't start this one with cold muscles. It's usually done at the very end of a full yoga session. Check that the shoulders are away from the ears and that the back is straight and strong. Now, visualize your posture and visualize where you're going to place the arms. They're going to be placed in a triangle, like this. So hold the hands together and place the elbows at a distance from each other, which is equal to the distance between the elbow and the hand. Again, don't crunch the shoulders in, but pull them away. Now you're going to place the crown of the head in the space between the hands and arms. One of the good advantages of this posture is that it places pressure on the crown chakra, therefore stimulates it. One of the many aspects of this posture. Alright, so keeping the shoulders away, keeping the back straight, you're going to place the crown of the head onto the mat, which automatically lets the back follow the move. Now you're going to tuck the feet in and raise the hips and pelvis by pressing on the feet. Here again, check that the shoulders are away, that the neck is long, and place most of the weight on the forearms, so you can raise the head like this. In fact, for a few weeks, you might want to do this exercise. Just raising the head up and down, making sure that the arms are strong. When you've practiced this for a few weeks and you're stable on the arms and forearms, you're going to start bringing the feet closer to the face, which straightens the back even more. And here, check that the neck stays long. And now, you're going to raise the pelvis above the shoulders, but keep the legs bent. Start playing like this. And come down, place the feet back, and rest. Rest for a minute or so. Now raise the head and check that you're feeling fine and happy. Spend some time observing what happens from the head down into the body. Observe the flows. We've been bringing a lot of blood into the head and eyes. It's an exercise that is very good for the eyesight as well. So observe what is happening now. You might feel a stream or a flow or energy, whatever you want to call it. You might feel it flow down into first chakra area. Just enjoy this. When you feel rested from this, continue advancing in the pause. Again, place the elbows and arms. Place the head. Place the knees. Tuck the feet in. Check that the weight is not on the head so much, but that is mostly on the elbows and forearms. Bring the shoulders away from the ears, lift the pelvis, bring the feet in,
And now you're going to try and stay with the legs bent, but with the back straight. Come down, one foot after the other, knees down, lengthen the neck. There's been a lot of weight on the head, so release the weight from the head, millimeter per millimeter, second after second, to go into child, and rest. Press into the hands, sit up. Observe. Enjoy. This posture really brings rejuvenation to the body and to the face. Observe what it does for you. That's always the best thing to do with yoga. Now, if this is so far all right for you and easy, this is the time to take it further. If it's not easy, what we've done so far, in that case, just continue practice this for a few weeks or however long you need before you move on to the next stage. Now here comes the next stage. This is the stage where you're going to raise the legs up. Is everything okay? Yes? All right, so then, forearms, hands, weight on the arms, strong shoulders, strong arms, head to the mat, shoulders away, and go. Breathe. Long, deep, powerful breaths. Feel the tummy relax, the legs are relaxed, the face relaxes, and breathe. come down whenever feels right for you. Releasing the pressure millimeter after millimeter, gram after gram. And rest in child. Place the hands near the knees, press into the hands, come up, and sit. And rest and enjoy. Now we're going to go into a more advanced part of headstand, where we're going to do some leg variations. Now, remember with headstand, as with any posture, the longer you hold it, the more benefits you have. Personally, I count how long I hold the posture with breaths. Say that when you start with 10 or 12 breaths that are comfortable. Then the next day you do it, move on to 13 or 14, and the next 15 and 16, and so on, until you come to at least 5 minutes, preferably more in each posture. Right, so now I'm going to show you a possible variation of headstand. As always, long neck, shoulders away, get into your triangle, place the head, place the hips and legs. These variations were about opening the legs and about bending one leg. You can do as many variations as you like. You can bend both legs, you can do it with a friend, and the friend also bends legs, then you get a crossing. You can open the legs to one side or to the other side. Play around once you feel comfortable. That's my best recommendation for enjoying yoga. Now then, when you finish the headstand, remember to have the counterpose to it, which is
which is the shoulder stand. So we've been applying pressure on the neck, now we're going to release that pressure into a shoulder stand. In most yoga sessions, shoulder stand comes before headstand, which is absolutely fine. In that case, you don't need to do the counter posture again, just do a few neck stretches. So shoulder stand goes like this. You need to have your complete mat open. Place all of the back on the mat, so tucking the hips up, lengthening the neck, long neck. The shoulder blades are together as much as possible in the back. And on a little oomph, you're simply going to bring the legs up to go into shoulder stand, which is one of the two or three very best yoga postures. It has similar benefits to to headstand, but it also is very good for the thyroid glands and parathyroid. Okay, good. Ready? Bring the knees relatively close to the chest and up. Support the back. And press the hands into the back, going further and further up. The legs are relaxed. Tummy is completely relaxed. The breath goes all the way to this part of the body. And to come down from shoulder stand, let the legs come backwards and let the knees come close to the face. Keep supporting the back. Keep the head on the mat and roll out. Vertebra by vertebra. When the buttocks become too heavy, place the hands on the mat, press into the mat, keep the head on the floor, come down vertebra by vertebra, place all of the body on the floor, and relax. Give yourself time to integrate everything that the body has done after any advanced yoga posture. Come out slowly, softly. Meditation is particularly good after headstand. So after this kind of session, you might want to sit up, making sure that all of the tummy is free, that the back is straight and relaxed. If not, remember to sit yourselves up onto something strong that can support you. And In this case, you would simply close the eyes and observe how much more vibrant the body feels and how much more at rest the mind feels. Keep this meditation going as long as you wish. That's it for me today. Bye-bye.